My name is Megan. I am the co-director of Cat's Corner Swing Dance School. I've been dancing for about 16 years, Lindy Hop and vernacular jazz. I like the social atmosphere of it, right? Like you invite someone to dance and then you're saying, yeah, I'm gonna look in your eyes for the next 3 minutes. And it's not a romantic affair, it's just like a friendly, we're gonna hang out together for the next 3 minutes. It's a cultural thing, right? It actually comes from a culture that's not mine. It comes from African American culture in the 1930s. So already we're a bit removed from it, but it absorbs the culture of the places that it's in, right? So things about Swedish culture, like in Swedish folk dance, they used to invite people for two dances, a fast and a slow. And now in Sweden, they still dance two dances because of that culture that stuck around, right? And so, what's interesting though is that even in all those places we all speak jazz, and that's the common denominator. And one of my mentors, a woman who passed away just a few years ago, her name was Dawn Hampton, and she lived in New York City, and she was a performer, and she was in a vaudeville family band when she was younger, and she would sit in the cafe at this dance festival in Sweden and look around at people from Australia and Lithuania sitting together and having a good time, and she would say, if only politicians knew how to dance, we'd solve all the world's problems. Montreal has a strong jazz culture, right? We've got some jazz greats who were born here, like Oliver Jones and Oscar Peterson, and there's a great jazz tradition here. One of our tap teachers here at the dance school, she's the granddaughter of Miss Ethel Bruneau, who came up from New York City with Cab Calloway's band and stayed and has been teaching tap here ever since. Mm-hmm. So there are many jazz traditions in the city already. And also there's a lot of opportunity to learn and dance. There's dancing every night of the week in different schools. There are many different schools at this party here today, showing their different styles and performances and stuff. So there's just a lot of opportunity and a lot of rich history. Cultural dance, but most of the people doing it today are not of that same culture.
Yeah.
So there are things that naturally shifted, but one of the questions we're asking ourselves is why don't we have more of the people who grew up in a jazz culture, in a social dance culture, doing this dance today? Is it because we have lessons and some people who are foreign to it want to come and try, or is it because we're doing something to make it not as inclusive as we could? So this is a big question we're sitting with, is like, we look around the room and we have a very common demographic in the room. And most of us are fairly uncomfortable with that. Like, there's no reason this dance can't be for everyone. So the thing that's happening now is we're asking a lot of questions and saying, what can we do to make this dance of the people, for the people, in the way that it was? Back at the Savoy Ballroom in Harlem, it was the first integrated ballroom of black dancers and white dancers coming in together. And anyone could swing dance. Now, it's still true, but you don't see anyone swing dance. So why is that? We're asking ourselves and we're trying to do that. That's good, it could go mean. Think fine.